Madam Magistrate.
Yes.
I am here under threat, arrest, and coercion. I'm not here because of an order. Because you as a magistrate cannot make an order. You can only administer ministerial duties. You have no jurisdiction to judge your own jurisdiction. I'll give you the citations on it. But we're going to review something. And this is something that took place with my original, which I put in the evidence before our first meeting. You refused to read it. You refused to accept it. I'm going to bring it in again right now. And this is the federal government's public law 719, which mandates your compliance with the Uniform Commercial Code. You have not done so. You have denied me of it. I gave you a lot of tools, two of them here. Two of them here right now. Affidavits, which you refuse to even acknowledge or accept.
Well, Mr. Marple,
they are on here, and I'm going to read. No, I am reading a judgment against you.
First off,
there are two judgments against you filed with the Secretary of State.
All right, well, Mr. Marple, what I'd first like to say in response is that you were provided two full hearings on your issues of jurisdiction.
You have no jurisdiction, and I'm going to read the judgments. This one is dated April 12, 2017, which said, affidavit of commercial default. This letter acknowledges and confirms as out of the state there has been no response or rebuttal delivered to this office as an answer to the affidavit of commercial default addressed to the Honorable Christian Spath, Magistrate, and Teresa A. McCaffrey, Clerk of Court, 6th District Division, delivered by Richard Marple and filed with the Secretary of State on March 28th. That's number one.
All right, well, hold on, please. I'm giving you the courtesy of speaking, and I ask simply for the same courtesy back. The first thing that I would like to say is that I have, in fact, read all of the documents that you have submitted to the court. I considered everything in my two previous orders where I denied jurisdiction. I understand that you still dispute jurisdiction, and the process under the Constitution when someone does that is to follow the appeal process. You will have an absolute right to appeal my decision.
You have no decision because you don't have any jurisdiction. I'm going to read into the records. If there is such a record,
let me just finish.
February 28, 2017. Reference affidavit of commercial default. This is on February 28th. This letter acknowledges and confirms that as of this date, there has been no response or rebuttal delivered to this office as an answer to the affidavit of commercial default addressed to the Honorable Christian Spath, Magistrate, and Teresa McCaffrey, Clerk of Court 6th Circuit District, Division, delivered by Richard Marple and filed with the Secretary of State on December 1st, 2015. Now, I put in sufficient documentation of serene diseases which denied you jurisdiction and you refused to accept it. You come out with what's called an order. You can't make an order because you're not a judge.
Well, Mr. Martin,
you're acting in an administrative capacity.
I continue to disagree with you.
The only question is a question of the law. You either obey the law or you are in violation of your oath of office and subject to RSA 92:2.
Mr. Marple, what I'd like to do right now is just remind you that I appreciate your being courteous to me as I am being courteous to you. There is no reason for yelling. We can continue to have what I would call a responsible and professional discussion. And my request to you, I have two requests. One is that when I wish to speak, that you give me that courtesy. And when you wish to speak, I will do the same. As long as we continue to be discussing what is relevant to today's case.
There is no relevance to today's case because you don't have jurisdiction.
And I understand that that is your position, but I would.
You can't get a sole jurisdiction. You denied that. The courts have denied you that.
Well,
you don't have that prerogative.
Mr. Marple, please allow me to speak. You have made your position clear.
You have denied me by procedural and due process rights under Article 15 of the Constitution, which demands you show me the affidavit that makes me liable for what you're assuming jurisdiction that you don't have.
And Mr. Marple,
I want to see it. Will you produce the document that has my signature that gives you jurisdiction? Will you produce that?
Will
you produce the document?
Mr. Marple, I'm going to ask you again to let me respond. The remedy for the position you have taken, which is that you disagree that I have jurisdiction, the remedy under the same constitution that you're relying on is to appeal my decision, or as you say, my non-decision, to the New Hampshire Supreme Court. That is the procedure that the New Hampshire Constitution allows when someone disagrees with the judge's order. So what I am saying to you in response to your discussion is that procedurally, to get where you want to go, which is to continue to challenge this court or anyone else's court's jurisdiction, the next step is to have the trial. You may not even be found guilty. If you are found guilty, then you have the right to appeal both the issue of the jurisdiction and a finding of guilty. Procedurally, that is how the next steps go. When you talk about the Uniform Commercial Code, that has no bearing on these types of cases. And I believe, and I maintain that I made clear in my two previous orders on the motions that you've requested, that it is the continued belief that there is jurisdiction.
Will you deny receiving an affidavit which incorporated the return of your purported judgment?
Oh no, I received that. That's
and did you file. Did you read what it says on there?
I absolutely did, sir.
And you know what the Supreme Court said, and I'm talking about Justice Grimes, in File 108, New Hampshire, 386, which was decided 12/29/67. Did you read that?
I read
it. And what does it say?
I read everything that you said, and in the last batch of the things that you sent, you're referring to the commercial code, the Uniform Commercial Code, and how a motor vehicle is a commercial good. And what I'm trying to explain to you, if you give me the opportunity again, is that those issues are not relevant to the charge of whether you operated a motor vehicle while your license was suspended or not. So that is where we have a fundamental disagreement, which you will have, again, ample opportunity to appeal to the New Hampshire Supreme Court.
No, that's already been done. The Supreme Court has settled the issue in what I just quoted, where Justice Grimes states very specifically that RSA, which you're compelled to perform under RSA 382A 9-109, defines the automobile as consumer goods. Consumer goods do not have to be registered. Consumer goods do not have to have a, quote, license, unquote, in order to travel in consumer goods.
Well, Mr. Martin,
there's no taxation. You're talking about extortion. Extortion from the people who do not know that there is a difference between an automobile and a motor vehicle. I gave you all that information. You refused to accept it. It's all documented. The Supreme Court's already made the judgment. But don't talk about appeals because there's no appeal for something that doesn't exist. Now, you won't hear that the last time I had the prosecutor over here deliver what was purportedly a license. It's not a license. It is a photo ID that I have purchased. And I put TDC, front direction coercion. That's not a license. It's my property. And there has been criminal conversion, C-O-N-V-E-R-S-I-O-N, depriving me of my property, which also has a contract with a very historic hospital lot. I want my property back.
All right, well, that's...
I've asked for it four times. You refused to give it to me.
Well,
that's conversion.
All right.
That is conversion. Criminal conversion.
Mr. Marple, please give me an opportunity to respond. All right. First of all, I have never made a decision on whether you get the license back or not. What you're arguing now is not something that is relevant to today's case.
There's no case today because you have been denied jurisdiction by your failure to answer the affidavits of proof.
Well,
Now, I want to see the affidavit that claims that I damaged somebody or I hurt somebody. I want to see it. It's my Article 15, due process. I want to see it. I want to be controlled. Article 6. Article 6 of the Constitution.
You're going around and around, and this is what I want to ask of you, all right? I have made two rulings that disagree with you, and let me finish, please. Please let me finish. I've been very courteous to you, and I'm asking that you show me the same courteousness. I've made two prior decisions that this court has jurisdiction. I understand you disagree, and we can go round and round and round, but we're not getting anywhere right now. What I am advising you is under the New Hampshire Constitution, the way procedurally that we need to go for you to continue with your argument on what you believe on your side is to have the trial, then you appeal. I understand your position is you don't believe that you even need to appeal because there's no decision. But both, you should understand this very well because you are in the general court, both legislatively and by the New Hampshire Constitution, that's how your rights allow you to proceed. So what I'm asking you is to allow the rest of this proceeding to go as it is required to do. You are not giving up any of your rights because you will have kept them all for appeal purposes, and you will be able to file a pleading and an appeal with the New Hampshire Supreme Court arguing what you have argued unsuccessfully with me. And maybe the New Hampshire Supreme Court will agree with you. But that, we have to get through this proceeding first before you can go to that next step. That's the laws that you and your fellow legislators have made, and that's what the New Hampshire Constitution says. So
yeah, I know what the Constitution says, and that's why I'm here. That's why my constituents elected me, for me to protect them from the avarice and greed of the corporation that you represent. Now, I checked with Dun & Bradstreet, and Dun & Bradstreet defined you as a mere employee of a bankrupt municipal corporation doing business in the Sixth Circuit under the paradigm of the Hampshire Supreme Court, which Dun & Bradstreet and the others also, the other companies that compete with Dun & Bradstreet, defined you as a private profit-making corporation, as the Supreme Court, under a contract to provide judicial services to another bankrupt corporation, which is the state of New Hampshire. There is no lawful money in circulation. That goes back to what I just showed you here, the Tax Lien Act of 1966, which apparently you don't understand, or you're going to avoid the fact that you're compelled. You are compelled to operate under the Uniform Commercial Code. You are not doing so. Therefore, you're in default. You're in default of your obligation and your subscribed contract to obey the Constitution, and you are subject to RSA 92:2 for violating your oath. Now, I've had enough. I ask you to recuse yourself from this because there's sufficient evidence to show your animosity toward me and spreading this out to justify the salaries that are being paid to these corporate employees. There's going to be a stop to it. Are you going to refuse yourself? I ask you that.
I'm not going to refuse.
You're not going to refuse yourself.
And let me put my reasons on the record. Please, again, I just ask for the courtesy of doing that. I do not believe there is any valid reason for me to accuse myself. I believe that I have been fair and impartial. I can continue to be fair and impartial. We are scheduled for a trial today, and I want to let you know that the trial is going to occur today. I would urge you to participate in the trial.
I'm not participating in something that cannot exist. It is a total fraud. You have committed fraud by your silence to two affidavits. You've committed fraud by denying me my procedural due process rights under Article 15. And I would like to submit, just for your own, there's two pages here. Is there a bailiff here?
What is it that you found?
Serena sees it after the Tax Lien Act of 1966, which everything prior to that is null and void. That's what Justice Breyer in Supreme Court case, define the automobile as consumer goods.
Right, Mr. Marple.
You will have to say, if you refuse to accept this?
Hold on, I think I already have.
Do you refuse to accept this?
I'm trying to clarify.
I'm going to ask you one more time. Do you refuse to accept this?
I am not refusing to accept it. I'm trying to clarify whether it's something I already have, because I believe you may have filed previously. Please, I'm asking you to be a little more respectful here. I am trying to help this situation, not hurt. So if you can tell me what the title of that document is, I will check, but I think I may already have it. If you'd like to tell me what it is, I will double check. All right, well, if you don't, I believe what I intend to do, Mr. Marple, is go forward with the trial today. I'm going to take your unwillingness to participate in the trial as you are voluntarily absenting yourself from the trial. The trial is going to go ahead, and you're welcome to stay. I would urge you to participate. Again, you may be found not guilty. You have the right to present any evidence that you want about the situation. But if you choose not to, you also have the right not to testify. But we're going to go forward with the trial today. You yourself mentioned that this has been carried on and going on for a long time. That was because I first wanted to give you the courtesy of thoroughly evaluating your motions. I have done that, and we're going to proceed forward now. Go ahead and call your first witness, please.
Then you were asking me to participate in a fraud, is that correct?
Well, I don't define it as a fraud.
Well, did you answer the two affidavits, Your Honor?
State calls Master Patrol Officer Fidala.
Your Honor?
I'm sorry, you're not a party to this matter, sir, so...
I require an appearance in a special non-representative matter, please.
You're too late for this piece right now.
Your Honor, you're